Last year I was so slow, you know, there's times I was only, you know, within a second, and I wasn't comfortable at all with my bike or anything last year. My goals was to be top 10. It's kind of funny, I wrote it down in my phone and my notes, like, be in the points every single race. You know, when I would tell people that, they're like, okay, well, don't set the goal too high. This class, obviously we're fighting for tenths, you know, we're fighting for a little hundredths of a second, so there's some doubt in your mind if whether or not you actually belong here. You're not gonna do very well.
First Q2, is this a pole?
First Q2, first pole.
Fucking crazy, huh?
When I came to this championship, all I ever wanted to do was put America on the top again, you know, like my heroes did when I was younger. And it's something that a lot of Americans have struggled to do. I'm obviously such a competitive person, so I really have always wanted to be the best, and not just for America, but just for me too.
To be honest, I've never felt more at home and actually love what I'm doing, and the job role that I have within the team is, to be honest, I've honestly never felt so good and almost feel better about it than I ever did about racing itself.
We knew that something is missing, and this is the chance to do something big. In US, there's a huge history of good riders, so we try to find a way to help those guys. We decided to switch completely everything and call it like American Racing Team, and create some kind of platform for an American rider to come and join the team as a rider.
Sorry, I'm always late.
No problem, he was arranging the gift for us.
Got it.
Yes. 16, Joe Roberts.
You have two HJC helmets already certified. Would you like to certify these two as well?
I think this one.
This one is done. That one is okay. This one is not.
Yeah,
would you like me to certify this?
Yeah, one? This one, please. I probably could have been a bit lighter. I got a bit bored this week.
This guy's amazing. Key to my success. Well, we haven't had any success yet, but we will.
Joe and I managed to find a way to work with. You know that I want the best for him because, you know, I start with him. Obviously, he's second year at the team, so I trust him, I support him. We have a few goals. One of them is to this year to try to be as top as possible at the championship, trying to get Joe to push as much as possible. I would like to see him in the top five.
You know, start working with the team. They wanted an experienced rider coach, obviously, with them being the American Racing Team. You know, all the while I was trying to speak to Joe the entire time and just telling him and asking him, you know, what are your strengths, what are your weaknesses? It's a really good feeling, you know, to be able to off with the experience that I gathered all the year. If I had something like that, you know, throughout my career, I think I really could have benefited from it. Joe really takes on board the advice that I give him, and to be honest, the perfect job, and I'm really, really loving it so far.
Well, the sun has set, the lights are on, and it's time for the Moto2 World Championship to have their second practice session of the decade and of 2020. So many title contenders, so many potential winners and podium finishers. Great stuff from Joe Roberts as he comes out the final turn. Will he maintain that sort of gap and go to the top? He does go top by 6.5 tenths of a second. Joe Roberts, take a bow. Great stuff.
Man, I made turn 10.
Yeah.
What? Like that? And then when I went in, I just fucking just died. You're my record, huh?
plan is to do even better.
Pole position.
Yeah, the plan is pole position. If I can do it today, I can do it tomorrow.
Maintainable, realistic goals that you've got to set. Yeah. And like, it's just funny. We've just shot up the entire ladder a lot quicker than I think. So that whole realistic goal thing that we set
is out the window now.
It's got to step it up a couple notches. So not showing your cards all at once can be a good thing in testing wise.
Yeah.
But you know, doing it on the race weekend is the perfect time and the better time to do it, because that's when you start intimidating people, and intimidation in racing is everything along with confidence. So,
dude, honestly, I feel like after today, I could just like do this at every track.
So
I don't know why, but
and just getting into the other riders' heads, that them knowing that you can do that at every track, yeah, is you win a battle right there.
Well, it's a very warm welcome to you. Good afternoon and welcome to the LaSalle International Circuit here, back on air to bring you qualifying. Oh, we're about to see history made here tonight in Qatar. Joe Roberts is on course. It's all about the Californian then. Joe Roberts, here he is, knee and elbow dragging on the deck as he comes through the third sector, and he is still up by over a tenth of a second. Joe Roberts here, surely at 57. It is Captain America.
Oh, it's the exact same lap time as Luca Marini.
We will have an American on pole position for the first race of 2020. Joe Roberts.
For the first time in 10 years, we have an American starting from pole position.
I don't think I was under any illusion that that wasn't going to happen. Everybody up here wants to win, so and I want to win too. So yeah, we're all going to fight for it, and it's going to be a great race, and you better tune in.
If someone told you coming into the weekend that you were going to walk away with here with a fifth place, you would have put your money down and like paid money for that, like at the beginning of the weekend, and not let the nervousness, and I know how jolting it is to like want that first GP podium. It's like, but you've literally, and if it comes down to it, like take the second, take the third, like, you know, yeah, if you can go for the win, go for it, but don't think it's absolutely everything.
No, I've thought about it, but it's always been in like when I've been like driving in my car, like listening to music, think going over like last lap battles in my head, getting like, I even get like butterflies, like
planning the attack is like everything.
But I also have like in the past, like in races before, I've like come down to like five laps to go and I make some dumb mistake and I crash or something.
Yeah, but it just keep your focus. And that's why I'm saying, like, study the riders, like make a plan in your head. You've got to keep that focus, and that helps you keep that focus. When you keep your mind focusing that whole time, you know, it's those times when you just don't think about anything where you make stupid mistakes. That's all you got to do is treat it like you've just done all the practices before. Just hit your marks, get into that rhythm, get into the flow.
I think Marini is definitely like, I don't know, I think he's got it on his mind. He said something in the interview post-race that like I was going to be someone to contend with.
Yeah, no, you are in everybody's mind. Like you're, that's it. Like that you are a known front runner now. Like they're focused on you. Like you're in their heads.
America is dependent on me. I must serve my country.
Everybody's watching you, man.
Every American.
Every American. Huh?
Don't do all the work for everybody. You know, it's they're going to be studying you, so study them as well. See where you can pass. See where your strong points are. See where your weak points are.
The first part, be calm. Don't look behind. Don't be aware of what they do. The others do your job. The others, they can do whatever they want.
Got this, man. Have fun. I don't think my nerves can take this anymore, man. I'm getting too old for this. You do all of this, all the travel, all the whole weekend, all the practices for this one moment.
The marshal walks, and now it's all eyes on the lights here in Qatar. Away we go, a good start from Luca Marini. Not such a great start from Joe Roberts. Bastianini regroups. He goes up into second, Roberts third.
Roberts back on the podium places, up the inside of Bastianini.
He needs to try and get away with Marini. Obvious.
He does not make mistakes. That's a lovely move. Yeah. Lovely move. Your classic change of direction from Joe Roberts as he goes back up into second place.
He's okay. He's got the pace.
Yeah. Do you know, yesterday in the press conference, Luca Marini was listening intently to every word said by Joe Roberts. He didn't know the guy. He's not considered Joe Roberts as someone that would fight him for any race or any world championship.
But he looks really comfortable.
He wants to try and learn about him. Well, he's about to find out, I think, what it's like to race in close quarters with Joe Roberts, because he's been closing and closing in the last couple of corners.
And these laps right now for Joe Roberts are just like gold. He's learning so much off the very, very best.
He's in the perfect position. He's letting them do the work. You just got to watch out for this guy.
The American Racing Academy, you can see there the sticker. It's being set up. And what a leader they have already in Joe Roberts. He's second at the moment.
Come on, Joe. Come on.
This is looking really good. Oh, a mistake from Marini. A mistake. Here comes Joe Roberts. He might even lose a couple of places here because Balder's coming through from third to first, but he runs wide. Through goes Roberts to take the lead of the race. Six laps to go. There'll be five when they cross the line. What a race we've got in line here.
You can't take your eyes off this one, ladies and gentlemen. Joe Roberts leads over the line to start lap 16. He's under intense pressure, though, from the Italians. Baldessari, Marini and Bastianini. You can't rule out Nagashima and Navarro just yet. Baldessari looks like he's going to be back on the podium. Gardner versus Roberts, what a classic battle. Those names have had in the past, but it's going to be Nagashima that's going to get it in Qatar. 10-2 Nagashima has won. What a race here.
Wow,
10-2
to Nagashima.
And Joe Roberts, well, you've got to give him an enormous amount of credit. His time will come. He has shown that he's capable of mixing it with the very, very best in the Moto2 World Championship. Roberts, a career best fourth place, his first top six. He missed the podium by just under a tenth and a half.
I don't know what to feel. I'm in this like in between. I'm super happy, obviously, because it's been a fantastic weekend and I've gotten my best result I've ever had in this class, and that's something not to take lightly, but I wanted to win so bad. More points than I accumulated in all 2 years of my racing here in the World Championship. So it's off to a great start, and you know what? Fourth place, I can be happy with it. I'm not like content with it. I want to be first, and I know we can be. I've got a great team and a great bike and great crew around me, so it's possible this year.